Right, there's some serious situations going on in Ferguson, Missouri. So let's bring in Benjamin Crump. He's the attorney for Michael Brown's family. You've been at the center of this since August 9th when this first happened with the shooting. The family is very concerned about what these shootings of these officers could mean. What is that concern?
Well, first, they offer their sympathies to the officers and their families. And I hope that the law enforcement community offers sympathies to her and her family as they continue to encourage the community to work with the police. This is not what they wanted. Violence is never the solution. So they are saying, work with the police so we can find these criminals who committed this heinous act. But more importantly, this is the opportunity for us to see how far we've progressed since August. The community and the police department in Ferguson trying to work together on a common goal, not just those findings from DOJ, because that is what we really want to get back to focus on, but also we're trying to find out who committed this heinous act.
And while we keep hearing that we don't want these shootings to be a distraction from advocates in the community, in a way, they are not a distraction. They're a part of the policing culture in this community that is going to affect behavior by police, not just vengeful behavior. You took shot two of ours, now we're going to be rough on you. But it goes to the mindset of your law enforcement officers that are here and what the community needs to put out as a message of respect.
Yeah, and what I hope is that the police will not see this as a them versus the community, and not even them versus the African-American community, but an opportunity to say, this, we can work together. The community and the police can come together, and we can get the results of not only sending a clear message to America that this won't be tolerated, we won't stand for violence, and we have some serious issues and problems we need to be focused on, and we don't need any distractions from that. So whoever did this heinous act, as we said before, is not a supporter of Michael Brown Jr. And Chris, think about what was going on. We were addressing finally these serious issues found in that DOJ report. And anybody who has been working with the Brown family, this is the last thing you wanted.
Right, because look, it proves, though, that there are deep issues here, that the police, there are risks to them in the community. That has to be addressed as well. I want to take a look at both aspects of the DOJ report. First of all, do you believe that there is any way that you can mitigate the strength of what was said about this police
Absolutely.
Department?
Absolutely. When we talk about the finding, there were two reports. The one report said that you had this pattern of discrimination and excessive force against African Americans. And they talked about this overt racism in these emails. But then, on the other hand, they said, but the police officer who shot Michael Brown wasn't affected by this. So you got to make sense of all of that. You got this cesspool of racism, but you're saying it's not going to spill over to the individual officers. So these are the serious problems we got to talk about.
Right. Now, we had Neil Braunschweiger on. He's obviously, he was a lawyer for Darren Wilson, but his big job is that he represents the officers in St. Louis County. He says, you know, that there were some premises, false premises in that report about the culture here, and it's really about a problem that's all over the country, not just Ferguson, that Ferguson isn't the problem. Do you agree with that?
Well, I think everybody in my community who's read that report, we say, well, that's what we've been saying all along.
Right.
We're treated differently by the police and so forth. However, you cannot deny those things in the report, the raw statistics.
And it's not simply that there are just more blacks, so blacks are going to be higher in every category.
Yeah. And remember this, Chris, there are bad actors in both sides. There are bad actors within the department. There are bad actors in the African-American community. And what we have to say is we want to make sure we hold everybody accountable. And so don't run away from this report. Don't try to deny this report. Let's say it's some serious issues we got to address, and if we don't get our head out the sand, nobody can move forward.
Now, you have the other aspect of the DOJ report, which is about the Michael Brown shooting. The criticism would be, why isn't the community coming out to support that finding the way they're supporting the findings about the culture of policing, saying, all right, they did their investigation. It looked like Darren Wilson, they believe, was telling the truth.
Well, you know what? The community is both. There are some people in the community that are supporting that. Now, I will say this. Look at the report for yourself, and you have to ask yourself, Chris, the kill of an unarmed teenager, when is he going to be cross-examined by anybody? I mean, ask the tough questions about the inconsistencies, ask the tough questions about why you had to shoot. because we haven't had that. And we
get
why
people
in the African American community just think, if that was us, the rules just different. They would be asking us all these tough questions.
But the system, it depends, right? It depends. If you didn't get indicted, then you would never be cross-examined by a lawyer for it. And you did have the grand jury.
And there lies the problem.
Well, it is a problem of perception.
But, yeah,
he went to a grand jury. They said he shouldn't be prosecuted. You had the DOJ, who everybody celebrated coming in here. Eric Holder, he's going to he'll make everything right. His findings are that they believe Darren Wilson. Why isn't that getting supported more?
Well, I think people are saying, when you look at all these killings of unarmed people of color, Eric Gardner, Tamir Wright, it's almost as if whatever the police officers do is sanitized. And once again, we're told our lives don't matter because the deaths are swept under the rug and no police officer is never held accountable. So are we to say that a police officer is never wrong when they kill a person of color? Because that's the message that's going out.
But look, you had the case with the kid coming down the stairs and the officer shot at him. He was indicted.
By the local authorities.
Every case is different.
Every case is absolutely different, but there is no denying the perception in America when people of color are killed that we're not given equal justice when it's the police on the other side. And that's what we got to deal with. We got to be serious about it, because if we want to have trust and faith on both sides, we got to say at some point, our police officers got to be held accountable for killing us too. And you look at the statistics, why is it happening at such an alarming rate in America today?
Understood. That's the problem. And the hard part is obviously finding an answer, not just the perception, but the reality.
We have a lot of work to do.
Well, appreciate you being here with us.
Yes, sir.
All right. Allison, to you.
Okay, Chris, we'll get back to you in a second, but